together with the Queen of Metal Universe. Yeah. The second edition already?
Yeah, it's the second book. The first book we made, I think, 2 years ago. In fact, it was a crazy idea, which we were having a tea. We were wondering, okay, what can we do? Okay, and one of us says, I make nice drawings. I write some poems, maybe we can make a book together. So that's how the idea was born, in fact. I was starting to collect the paintings and whatever we wrote. When we wrote the book, we were actually surprised how people kindly responded to the book. So then we decided to make a second edition. And that was released right now at the Metal Female.
And you're proud that there is a second edition?
Oh yes, I'm very happy about it. It's very emotional because it's something that that is part of you. It's coming to life, it's coming to reality. So it's very, very touching.
Mm-hmm. What are your feelings about which books?
It's emotions. Emotions that we all have inside. It's a fantasy. Because, for example, when you are dreaming, you are entering like the other world. You can be anybody. You can be a fairy, you can be a bird or a dog. And after, when you wake up, you start to contemplate all the feelings. How can I think of transfer the other reality into the paper? So, that's a little bit the subject. It's a subject. Fantasy, emotions, psychology, anything that comes, you know, to you, that normally people will not speak about it, but you feel when you have a lot of something, you want to do something.
So inspiration comes from your dreams?
Dreams, fantasies, imagination. Yeah.
You made, I think, 100% of you did the book Vietnam.
Yes.
And you made 120%?
Something around that. It was actually surprising because, okay, you never know if you will present more from the people. But it was pleasant to see that people actually faith in your talents. As we all know now, those days, okay, there's crisis everywhere, and then you don't know if you actually want to support it. Can help you. But we don't see that actually. They believe in you. They want you pre-order the book. It's like, oh my god, I will start to cry because it's so touching. No, the people believe in you.
Yeah. You pay in advance to get something.
Yeah, exactly. So, but when I saw, you know, the past, the limit, I was like, oh my god, this is happening. Yes, you can make it. Thank you. Thank you. It's beautiful.
So, what will you do with the extra money when you get other fans?
We will make
a purpose
for the next
one. Yes,
that's
you don't know about it, eh? You don't know about it. And you offered also your shoes and a corset as a pearl.
Yeah.
And you took them.
The shoes were taken by Jack Williams in the States. And the corset was in fact just won by a guy that had a dog and who will receive the next concert. So
I bet he's really curious.
Yeah.
So speaking about your band, what's happening with your band right now?
Right now we are working on our next album, which released next year. It will be also a combination of our music and the comics, because in fact it's our we make only two comics. The first comic was for one song because we just wanted to see how it will go, like the idea, because you never know, but people like it. And you should do something more. Then we spoke with the band, why not to make, you know, full album, each song for each chapter. Let's see how it will go, And we started to work on it, and it took us 2 years to complete it, because every song had to fit into the chapter of the comic. Yeah. And when you listen to the music and you watch the comic, it fits together. So it's not, you know, oh, okay, I will do whatever, and you can do whatever. No, we have to work together, so it is actually, it matches, really matches. So for the next cycle, it will be the continuation of the preface. The same.
Sounds good. I think with the Temptation did something similar, but it was years ago that they had a comic too for them.
I don't know, maybe.
Okay, it will be a lot of touring then for the next year.
Yeah, for the next year, that's all I can say. But it's coming.
Looking forward to that. And now I have a question which we've been asking all the bands. This festival is called Metal Female Voices Fest, so it has the term female voices in it. How do you feel if someone says your band is female fronted metal? Is it something that offends you, or is it just a sticker someone has to put somewhere in the community?
Not at all. I'm a female. For me, it's okay. It's normal. Metal female fronted band. Okay. For me, it's nothing offensive. I'm a female. Why should I feel, you know, offended by someone else being female? But I know some people say, oh, you put the sticker on me because I'm a female, and on the guys you put nothing. As long as you don't call me, you know, names, I'm okay, yeah? But why should I be, you know, objective for such kind of thing? I don't know, it's my opinion. I'm okay with it. I'm a female, I sing in the female band. Okay!
So it's just, they're just right because...
They're just right because... For me, true.
Okay, thank you so much for the interview. Is there anything else you want to say to your friends?
Yes!